Go.
Hey guys, we're back with Darling in the Franxx Blue. And to start us off, we have an Ichigo. Go away. Discord is getting in the way of everything. Ichigo, Swinging Feelings. This is a 0015 brainstorm. Up to once turn, when you play an event, give a character 1k for a turn. I mean, that's a fine effect. I don't think it's super impactful, but the other effect is a self-tap brainstorm, pay one, tap, and mill fourth. Every climax, search your deck for a character with Parasite or Franxx. I don't, again, I think we've been over this. I don't think the difference between search and salvage is really something that you care too much about. And as a result, you look at other things about the deck, about the card, rather. This one, I don't think the event thing is very impactful. I do think it's a little bit more impactful than the 0-2 in red, but I think the other deciding factor is that this is blue and therefore will never fix or anything unless you play Chlorophyton. Basically, if you play blue top end, then this might be your brainstorm choice. If you don't, then you'll probably be playing red because basically every deck plays red. And that is probably how I would evaluate this. It is the same rating, and you choose based on which one is better for your deck. Also, I think this one is probably cheaper right now, so that's another reason to pick this one. All right, next card is, I mean, we all gave it a B plus because that's what we seem to give brainstorms. Ikuno, Secret Feelings. This is a 0025. When it becomes reversed, so not when it's put into waiting room, when it becomes reversed, you may reveal up to three cards from the top of your deck. If you do so, choose up to one Parasite or Franxx there, put in your hand, ditch the rest, and discard a card from hand. So it is a Rize effect on reverse. It is a, I guess it's Kirito or whatever. This is a welcome discard outlet. This is a welcome mill effect. Because it happens on reverse, you can use it with cards such as the 0-2 storybook combo, and I don't know what else to say. I guess you can save it with clean cut to be used again. This is a it's a fine card. I think that having this sort of mill utility at level zero is something every deck actively wants. And even though this one is not immediate, and you can't get it like you can with Kirito by playing over it, it is still strong enough to warrant a place in basically every Franxx deck. So I'm gonna give it a B plus. Tom, why do you think it's a B?
Doesn't do anything else.
I'm just, you just had a different fitting, so.
I've been valuing on attack optional mill a lot more lately. I really like being able to hedge and have some climaxes in a small deck and say, I'd like to hope they stay in there, but this lets me hedge against them not staying in there. That's cute.
I think I'd like this more if this were a level one, but
Interesting.
that might just be me.
I mean, that gives it more power to work with, and that's usually fairly desirable. Being able to use it at zero is not particularly helpful. I don't think it's a detriment, but I also don't think it's too helpful.
Guess I.
On the other hand,
If it
it
were
does
something
need
like
more
the
color.
Kirito from Sao, I'd bump it up to a B plus or even an A minus maybe, but
Yeah, it's
this
fine. It's
just
not on
does
play.
yeah this just does this and it doesn't fix for a good color, so
Sure. I have two things to ask. One is the, can you elaborate with a couple more sentences or one more sentence about, you said the storybook level 1-0-2 combo, is that what you said?
it bounces back. So if you manage to
Okay.
attack with this and it doesn't die, then you
Ha
very much are
ha
idiot.
ha. So
This
you
this that's not how it works at all.
Yeah.
It's not a reuse at all. So never mind me. I'm just
Well, if your opponent's bad, they'll
I guess the second thing though is this card does not appear in my list very
what
often.
happens is like well, I mean, either way, you either deny reverse or you get your
Oh wait.
effect, right? So they can kill this and get the reverse
Never mind.
and then attack the 0-2, or they can attack the 0-2 and then you just get a card back
Sure.
and you don't lose the card.
It's hard to say that would be
So
actually synergistic, though.
yeah, synergy, but the synergy is not right there.
I don't end up playing this card very often. This was a very big surprise to me, and I hate to give Tom or Tim Tom any ground on this, but this might be the first level zero of this kind of profile that I think is not an automatic four of.
It's just a B, man.
I was so worried you were about to say that you'd rather play the drop searcher. I was so worried. You have no idea.
Both of them mill three.
And both of them might be...
both of them are costless.
Yes.
This is not necessarily a four of, but I still think it's an auto include.
I think it's arguable. This might...
It is fine.
I'll just have a parting shot of this might not make it into decks, even though it's a good card.
It might not. But that's a space consideration rather than this card not being good. It's just that other cards are either more necessary or just straight up better.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Next card, Delphinium. When it attacks, if Envy Chop... No, that's not right at all. This is G and Bishop is in the climax zone and there are five or fewer cards in hand. This gains the -2 soul effect. So the reason I take issue with this is because that climax name is stupid. What the hell is an Envy Chop? You know what? I'm changing that right now.
What?
I'm changing the Heart of the Cards text.
Nice one.
Yeah, that upsets me. Like, there is a very clear theme here. Please stick to it, Heart of the Cards. It's a pants, for the record. At the start of your opponent's draw phase, this in the front row, give one of your characters 4k for the turn. So, pretty typical 4k buff, and it's a -2 soul as well, which people really like more than they should. That being said, it's not terrible here. The additional requirement is barely a requirement. If you're trancing multiples, it's quite easy to have 5 or fewer cards in hand. And having a whole bunch of power means, anything short of an anti-change bomb is probably just going to roll its face on it. What do you guys think?
I think whenever people talk about this, I think the first thing that gets brought up is just anti-change bombs.
Sure.
Which hurt a lot more here because... you as the Franks player have invested more here than you would with other decks that run -2 soul combos.
I mean, in fairness, they have done a fair amount of their job by denying an entire attack turn's worth of damage, right?
Mm-hmm. But
that's true, but like, what's your hand, basically?
Yeah, no, I agree with that.
Like, especially if you got this combo off, right? You're gonna have 5 cards in hand, draw 6 cards, and now you have to replace 3 lanes.
Mm-hmm.
I'd be more okay with this if it did not have the draw phase 4k. If this healed on play, like...
Kotori.
Yes. So, for Kotori, you get a lot out of the combo and the on-play effect already.
You get half! You get half of this power boost from Kotori's marker effect, which is funny.
I thought that these two effects were pretty cool together, but if they anti-change bomb you, then they eat the minus soul penalty, and if they challenge you with a level 3, then they lose their level 3, at least at counterstep, but probably they're just not even big enough anyway. So I thought these two effects worked pretty well together, but this felt like total crap to play with. If they got answered, you were done.
You mean you don't like not having hand?
I was really disappointed with this card in practice.
I think it's just you not having hand is not a good thing. Right?
Sure.
Alright, I'm going to give this card a C. Because while I can see it being extremely snowbally and powerful, in most of the situations where it's snowbally and powerful, Strozier is going to do a similar job. And I think that card is the... component cards of that combo are better than the component cards.
It's even comparably as big. To be honest. Yeah.
Next card. This one is Futoshi loves eating. If there are two or fewer cards in stock, he gains 1/5. It is a, you know, just a 4K. This is, I think, a fine card. I don't really have an objection to this card. What else can I say? It's a 4K.
Yeah, a 4K, but as you mentioned, there's nothing worth splashing for. If you're going to do double early play package, the double early package almost color fixes for itself. You barely need any other blue cards. And the level 1 plans, as we'll get to, are very uninspiring and not worth splashing for. Not worth playing, so if this is in your deck to splash for level 1, your deck is bad. And there are a couple of tech cards in blue at especially in the trial deck or the box topper early play that looks at top 3. Those might be worth having blue for, but I think I'm just lower on oversizes than you guys are. I think they're fine, but they are not, you were not excited about them. They just fulfill a role that you need filled.
Yeah, that sounds about right. I mean, that's
because you like them. You like to attack with a card and live and attack with it again. That's fine.
Okay, next card is our Kokoro, Hope and Interest. This is cost 0 bomb. When it becomes reversed, you can put the cost 0 battle opponent on the bottom of the deck, and when it's placed from stage to waiting room, you can pay 2 to search your deck for a Parasite or Franks out of hand. I don't know, I'm not too impressed with this particular card. It basically always goes to the waiting room, I guess, if that's something you care for.
Yeah, I only see this being relevant in a deck that really wants to do one of the double early plays, but also for some reason is shy on a level 1 combo succeeding, or maybe doesn't even play the level 1 combo. It's sad that this is a Kokoro, but it does not actually interact well whatsoever with the level 1 Kokoro double R stock charge, because this does not reverse its battle opponent. It bottom decks it, so you can't stack your stock charge on this. So even though the stock payment would be most effectively, you know, put to use in the stock charge deck, this does not synergize with it all that well.
I think it's a fine card to have access to. I think it's a heavy meta call if you ever need a cost 0 bomb. But I also think that you probably won't. So let's go with C minus. Alright, next card. Ikuno, Chlorophyton's Pistol. When this is placed from hand to stage, you can pay 2. If you do, search your deck for a blue Climax and add it to your hand. That's actually really cool. And it has merged with Mitsuru, Chlorophyton, Stamen to get Chlorophyton onto the field, which we will cover in, I think, like 2 cards time or something.
Yes.
Basic question that a person might ask is this effect, the on-play effect of pay 2 search of blue Climax, is that better or worse than the shuffle?
You mean to put 2 into your deck?
Yeah, not shuffle. Yeah, to put them on the bottom of the deck. I always say shuffle for some reason. And I think you're trading one form of consistency for another form of consistency. Sometimes your trans level 3s won't be in the deck because this doesn't have the put 2 in. But sometimes you'll get the Climax because you have this effect instead. So it's kind of a wash to me.
I think it's a wash. I do think that if trance is always your plan and multi-trance is always your plan, then you probably value the put 2 copies a bit more.
Mm-hmm.
But this does get you your Climax, which is a big part of why Chlorophyton is one of the quote-unquote better advanced summon. I do think that without the Climax combo, this is Chlorophyton is comparable or arguably even worse than Streltsia, because it really does not have very much power.
This is worth maybe being a one of if you're going to do the minus 2 soul plan.
I really don't like that. It's not 2-1, though.
Yeah, it sucks that it costs you 3 total stock, but I think it's probably still worth putting in the deck as a one of. If you're already doing this plan of the Chlorophyton plan, then your Dr. Franks gets a little better. You can more reliably bounce things. This is fine.
You know, he's technically not wrong. I don't want to admit it, but he's technically not wrong. I'm gonna give this the same rating as the as what's her name, as the 02, because I think that's about where it is.
I didn't bring up that Argentia, the on-play salvage, the wind, the level 3 yellow mech. I didn't bring up that helps Dr. Frank, so I wanted to sneak that in for this one, too.
Yeah. You're not wrong.
Okay.
Yeah. All right, next card is Ichigo, Delphinium's pistol. So this is a... Yet another Trancer. Sorry. This one's just a typical Trancer. Put two underneath, This is a C. It's pretty inherently tied to how good the how good the trancing effect is. The trance target is, as it usually is. And I think this one's fine. It's the -2 soul plus 4k, 4k1 for the record. So it's probably the most likely not to die, but it's also not a particularly proactive one. You don't recu any hand, and that can be an issue for a lot of people, me included, and therefore I think I prefer to either get Chlorophytum or Chlorophytum mostly. I don't think Grotty is very good. That's no point. C's about where I have it. Next card. So this is Chlorophytum, the Ikuno trance target. It is a heal when you play it from hand or when you merge into it. And when this attacks, give wings pawn, not wingspan, it's wings pawn, please. That this actually upsets me a little. Is in the climax set. You can draw up to one card, and then this gains +2k and -1 level until the end of your opponent's next turn. This is cool because that means you dodge on the anti-change stuff. And this has the potential to twin drive, so you can pay one to trigger check twice.
This thing's small.
Yeah.
Which bothers me, but I like it. And I think a lot of people like it. This has emerged as like the main plan for a lot of people. It's either this or Strelitzia.
It's the big level 2 beater, man.
Yeah. Sometimes the fact that they can side you hurts if you like hit them up to 3. That's occasionally you're upset that you give them reasonable side attacks. Normally, siding level 3s is not profitable. Siding level 2s can be. But I like this. I wish it were a little bigger.
But, is it feasible to run this Sanjinista? Or is that not happening?
Yeah, but I think the real... I think what you're driving at is it feasible to do that at the same time,
yes,
rather than having the same deck. And it helps that the Futoshi level 0 can pay 2 search to find missing pieces, and it helps that this has no stock cost whatsoever on its combo. So you can spend all your stock to, you know, play 2 of this and the Janista and search for a total of, I think that's 5? Yeah. And 2-1. So, yeah, I think it's doable. I've done it sometimes to have the real board of, you know, 2 of this and 1 of the Janista. And that's a pretty good board. That's great. It helps, too, that this, you know, can draw into your gloves. You can draw into your counter steps. Even if you hadn't sculpted for a counter step plan, this can draw you into one.
Yeah.
A lot of lists play this, play a couple gloves along with this.
Alright.
Nice card. Or not bad card, rather.
Yeah, I agree.
I have tried to play this alongside Strelitzia, but that requires you to be a complete sack. No level 1 combo, just play this and then draw into pieces. You put Magical Gorilla Piers into this. But at least it is an idea to play this and the Strelitzia burner and have like a 1-2 punch. It's worth maybe trying to refine.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Cool. Next card. This is Mitsuru, Chlorophytum Stamen. This is Chlorophytum's trance requirement. gives all level 0 or lower characters in front 1k power, so this actually does make the 2-2 Nana bigger. I'd like to point that out. And when you trigger a climax card, give a character 2k for the turn. Look, this is only as necessary as
Chlorophyte.
And unfortunately, this is one of the worst cards that you'd be forced to play in order to use it. So my score is a C minus, because you need to play it, but you don't really want to play it. It doesn't do a great deal.
It kind of sucks that this is very small power, but
I'm swapping down to a D plus, but that's still we're close. Yeah,
I do think that pumping your 4Ks and runners is not enough.
Or your clean cut level 0, that's pretty good too.
But it's you'd rather this be a global for your clean cut.
Sure. There, worth saying, there's another the partner shuffle for this as well. I think as a card, this is worse than the other card when we get to it. But this is a level 0, so it can attack at 0. So it's not a total apples to apples comparison. But I think this is worse than the one we'll get to. So, that does mean though you can play. I will
eight
say you probably
put this in the deck. Targets.
This sucks, but yes, you want to put a couple extra trans targets beyond the 4 in the Chlorophytum deck. You might as well. So this ends up making the cut, even though I don't think it's a very good card.
All right, next card, Kokoro, full persistence. This card is so close to being there. When this is placed from stage to waiting room, you can pay 1, clock the top card of your deck. If you do, look at the 3 cards from the top of your deck, add 1 character there to hand, and then put the rest in waiting room. There are a few reasons why I don't think this is quite good enough. Key among them being that it's on death, and because you can't take non-characters. So while I can appreciate it for its effect, I also think it's kind of mediocre.
It's a mediocre card. I think if it were green, then people would be tempted to play it, but it's in blue. I actually thought it was green for a while when I did a little table of all the reasonable effects for deck building purposes. I had this under green. It ended up making a couple lists, and I realized it was blue, and it immediately left every single list I'd put it in.
Nice. I've definitely seen sillier things happen, but yeah, it sounds about right. Okay, next card, Ichigo, hair accessory. This activates up to once a turn. When you play present for you, give a character 2k for the turn. I'm just going to give it an F. I don't think that this is anywhere near playable. It's an effect that is not particularly great. and the cards that you play it with is fine, but you already have other cards you'd rather play in that increase consistency rather than increase the effect of the event.
Yep, it's a bad card. Don't play it.
It is not a good card.
Even in full present package, don't play the card.
Okay. Next card. So the PowerPoint has the name wrong. And there's the Persona 3 battle song has a bit where it goes moment of fate, moment of fate. And that's the only thing that I can think of right now. So mass destruction is going through my head. This is Ichigo, Under the Stars. I didn't look at the hard cards translations. I'm just a weeb who can read kanji. It's a 1/0 3k. If there are one or it's this card. If there are one or fewer other characters in your front row, this gains 4k power. And when you have the book starting Shooting Star Moratorium in your climax zone, if you have one or fewer other characters in front row, put up to 2 cards from the top of your deck in stock, and this gains 2k power till the end of your opponent's next turn. How do you feel about cards which gift your opponent a free cancel?
This sucks.
yeah, it does.
So you have to appreciate that at least it's 9,000 on the opponent's turn. You only attack twice, so your opponent probably didn't level up. So we'll still be at level 1. So against a lot of decks, I can't kill this. That's cool.
That's cool is a way to put it.
You will probably get both of these cards to live. And that's not nothing. But I would never seriously consider playing this.
I agree.
I think it's better than like a lot of people would think.
Yes, I think so. But what this card effectively says is you're assuming your opponent's your third attack is going to be cancelled. And that's the best case scenario. And therefore I'm just gonna give it a D plus because I think that even if it's better than people give it credit for, it's still pretty lousy.
Mm-hmm. Giving up attacks at level 1 is the worst time to give up attacks. Or first deck, it's the worst time to give up attacks. This would be better for
level 3 is actually the worst time to give up attacks, but I think so anyway. You can make an argument for it, but that is my thought. Okay, next card. Hachi, Commander of the City Defense. Neg 1 level on stage, so it's boosted by that. I've already forgotten his name. And for each of your other level 0 or lower characters, gains 500 power. So that includes the other Nanas. I don't really want to keep talking about this card, to be honest. Like, I'm joking about a lot of this, but in reality, this is just not a playable card. Alright. 0-0 Goro. 500 power in the front row center slot. Oh, that is so upsetting. This is terrible. This is terrible flavor. You can pay one and tap both this character and another character to get a present to your hand. And then for real flavor, you have to keep that present in your hand till the end of the game and never play it. What do you guys think? Do you think this is worthwhile?
This probably only makes it into a present deck, right?
Yeah. I mean, I'll talk a little bit about what this card does here. So it rests self. That has to be stressed. You cannot rest two other characters. You can't use one girl to go off in the way that I'm describing. But what you can do is your deck uses trance, which means that you get extra rests out of characters that will then leave the stage and become markers. So you can reliably have cards to rest. So you could have a field of like a Brainstorm and a Goro. You can normally you can't do both because Goro himself and another without like giving up cards. However, because you're trancing, you can Brainstorm and Goro using the trance target or using the trancer like 0 of the 2. So that's cool. You can even do double Goro to get 2 pluses main phase in one turn if you use your trances to pay for the rest. If this did not rest self, then this would be very, very good. But it does. You end up needing multiple copies of it if you want to like go off or whatever. It has good interaction with trance. It gives you a pay 1+. The pay 1+, though, won't be really good because the present event is not that slow. It's not that helpful. My last thing I'll say is if your deck is small enough, then the trance level 2s that put cards into the deck interact quite well with this card. Say you have a one card deck or something. Okay, you manage to get a one card deck. You play the trance level 2 that puts 2 level 3s on the bottom. Then you Goro, salvage the event, play the event, mill 2 cards, which leaves 1 card left, but mills a level 3. You then grab a level 2. You play the level 2. You should put 2 level 3s back under. You Goro again. Grab the event, play the event, mill 2. So there is a sequence here that is interesting. It's hard to make happen because if you're going to do the level 2 on time, then you're usually in second deck, the beginning of second deck, not the end of first deck. So the timing doesn't really quite work. But sometimes that happens, and that's cool. I think this card is reasonable. I think it's better than maybe you'd think it deserved to be. I'll do B-.
It's a one cost plus. I really can't dock it too many points. Yeah, I think it's a fine card. I do think that needing to run the present stuff is a minor downside, but you can work around that, really. Okay. Next card. Goro, Delphinium Stamen. What is wrong with me? Yeah, so it's a 0/0, 1k, assist 500, and when you play a climax, give something 1k for the turn. So this is, it's literally, what's it called?
Goro's Married Life. This is fine. It's, obviously, you needed if you're going to do the trance for Delphinium for Ichigo. And it gives you power for your level 1 combos. It's reasonable.
Mm-hmm.
Decks in the past have played this without a need for trance. I think it's fine.
Mm-hmm. Fine is where I've landed on it. Okay. Next card is Angry Futoshi. If this is on the stage, it's also Mitsuru. Attacks against one against 500 times the number of your opponent's characters. And it has character encore.
And of course, which cool is... for a card like
yeah,
this.
Yeah, I like this. It's not just because it's Futoshi.
Oh.
No one was asking you about that, but sure.
This guy's on Team Futoshi.
I have become very aware of the fact that I rate every Futoshi card is better than every Mitsuru card. But I can't help it. His cards are just better.
Oh, that. Sure.
You probably in your deck building weight your, you know, you probably play more of this than you would of the Mitsuru.
Have you been to any body image sermons recently or something? I'm joking because I know this guy in real life and he's not tubby, but
I'm okay with how I am, just like Futoshi is.
This card is fine. I yeah, I think it is fine.
Mm-hmm. You can attack with it and then hand on court and it'll be on stage for you to trance, not like that crappy level 1 Mitsuru.
Well, you could also attack with it again and that's not the worst proposition.
That's true.
All right. Next card, Ikuno at the beach. Oh god. 1/0/5/5. At the beginning of your attack phase, if there's one or few other characters in front row, put up to 2 cards from the top of your deck into stock. So No shiftiness here, okay? You don't get to, like, run your Goro in and get him into stock and then have 2 characters. No, none
oh,
of that shifty,
man.
None of that shifty shit here. Yeah, so the idea behind this is you play 2 copies of this and the Ichigo. You run one in and it dies, but you've gotten the 2 stock from both copies of the Ikuno, and then you now have the ability active of now your Ichigo's has only 1 other card in front of row, so it is able to do its stuff. So you get a crap ton of stock like this, but it's not particularly good.
I think the Ichigo is when the climax is played to climax zone, fortunately. So even that shenanigan doesn't work.
I hate this card.
Yeah.
This card is awful.
every cute idea, like it that you get, that doesn't work. But maybe this does. No, it just
okay.
It just doesn't work.
I'm gonna stop giving them
nothing
the benefit
works
of the doubt. I'm just gonna stop. I'm just gonna start assuming it's all garbage. This card again incentivizes you to attack fewer than 3 times level 1, and that's rubbish. Don't play it.
This can be played later though. So I think it is possible that some decks would put it in.
This would have been pretty good in, like, 2012.
What are you going to do? Attack, play it later, and then bottom on reverse.
My sales pitch is not very big. So I think of this as a level 2 card. It says level 1 in the top left corner, but it's actually level 2. You play it at level 2 when attacks have the least return because they're more compressed at second deck than first. So you're giving up less, at least. It represents a way for you to get stock without using a ton of your hand, so it would have a role as a few copies in a deck that commits all of its search power toward an end game, but then doesn't always, you know, have an ability to find just playables to keep attacking. So then, maybe like, in the present deck, this would be okay as a couple.
But this is a playable that needs to be gotten at a specific time in response to a specific game state that you are only aware of when you start your turn. Yeah.
I think this is a good card. Can I ask you a
more pointed question? Yeah. How much money would I have to pay you for you to play a deck that does not times at level 2 at like a WGP? Like, how much money would you need?
Not playing this. Yeah.
my point I'm trying to make is that attacking less than 3 times is actually not something you should account for within the game design.
Okay,
attacking
sure.
is not only pushing your opponent towards level like their refresh, but you get actual resources from attacking. You get information about your opponent, like how many climaxes they have out, whether they're likely to counter, the sort of things that they've committed. And more importantly, your opponent is assuming that you're going to attack 3 times. So they've prepared for that. And if you attack 2 times, you're basically handing them cards. So
you can play this against Negsoul.
Okay. Would you like to do that? How much money would I have to pay
instead of attacking in the third lane, you play this, right? Because attacking in the third lane against Negtusel without any way to deal with Negtusel is just not good. It's not a good attack. It's like worthless, actually. It's very close to being worthless. It doesn't
get one stock from this. What are you talking about? You get an extra stock from this, actually.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay, sure. So, again, how much money would I have to pay you for you to put this into a Darling in the Franks deck?
If I had a Darling in the Franks deck.
Yes. Let's just assume you're playing it for WGP.
Yeah, sure.
How much would I?
Am I running blue? Like, I don't know, man.
You have to run, the problem is, you have to run blue, three right? of this.
I think the problem is just...
I
have to run three of this?
Yes. Otherwise, you're never going to get it.
I wouldn't play three of this.
I wouldn't play three of this.
I wouldn't play any of this.
Maybe it's a one of.
The deck that makes this really good sucks. Okay? But even in a reasonable deck, this can do fine things on field. Because like, it generates you stock without spending hand. So, sure, like you dealt less damage that turn, but that might mean you're able to do level 3. Like, you have more resources to do whatever. For just 2 attacks, you generate the same amount of stock as if you'd spent 3 cards. So, that there's an appeal there, but I understand that we need to caution people. This card is not good. Do not leap to play this. This is like not a card that you actually want to play, but I don't want to give it a.
Let me play field. Then, without any other input, what 2 turns worth of stock in 1 turn at the cost of only 1 attack? When you put it like that, kind of still completely terrible because the value of stock is not the same as the value of an attack. Let's move on. Alright, next card. Goro sending off. This is the Shizuru counter. It's a 1-1 counter for 1/5. When you use the backup of this, check the top card you would take. Put it either on top or bottom. This profile sucks. Yeah. So, that's way better than it is.
I think I rate counters a lot lower in general now.
Yeah.
Did I talk about it in an earlier video for this set review? Yep. I think I did.
About the one Futoshi counter.
Yeah. Look, from my perspective,
everything I said about that card applies here, but possibly even more because like this scry effect is just not like game change. It's like very, very minor impact.
It does very little. Like it seems like it's a lot because it's a way to interact with your deck during the battle phase, which is not common, but the actual amount of times it changes what happens in the game is very, very low.
It's like less, it's slower impact than like a damage scry. Except like with a damage scry, you get possibly multiple, like a single instance of damage scry is not even that impactful. But this effect is even less impactful than that.
No, I mean, sometimes this does literally nothing, and instead all you've done is play an over an under-spec costed counter. So you've paid one to scry one. Would you ever pay one to scry one? I'm not sure you would.
No, I wouldn't either.
Alright. Next card, 2-1 Mitsuru. All your other Parasite or Franks gain 1k. When your trigger check reveals a climax, give a character one soul for turn. This one's better than the ones that give power when you trigger a climax, I think. Or, I mean, it's a debate you can have. I think, on average, it's slightly better. I don't think it's better than the hero, because 2k is a lot of power. But, I wouldn't fault anyone for running it, really. Like, it's not a terrible card or anything.
It works all okay right, next with level 2 cards.
Yeah.
It's one of the better cards that nobody will play.
It supports the 2-2 Nana, because it doesn't have any level requirement. Alright, next card. Goro, first time at the beach. 217k. When another character with Parasite or Frank's attacks, this gains 500 times the number of your other characters. So, oftentimes, it's an extra 2k power. That means this can attack last as an 11k frequently. And then it's got character on call. I don't really think I ever want to play this card. I think that if I wanted to play something like this, I'd rather play the 0-2, the red one. And even taking that into account, an 11k is not even big enough to deal with most advanced summons that have a support behind it. So the fact that it is Encore is kind of relevant, but the fact that it's kind of relevant is not a good thing, because that means it's going to die pretty frequently. So yeah, D plus is where I'm at. It's not a terrible card, but it's probably outclassed. Alright, next card is present for you. This is the blue version. It is a 1-1. It's gloves. 1-0. It's 1-0. It's gloves. It's just gloves. The thing about gloves is that gloves wasn't broken because it was gloves. Gloves was broken because of the cards around it. Specifically the Clock Bond, which is probably one of the best cards in Rewrite. And as a result, this card specifically is nothing special. It is mediocre. It is something I'd rather not play this card.
The yellow event is probably better with the slots, right? This is like...
Oh yeah, that's not a question.
This has an awkward relationship in the package, because you can't really run too many of this, I think, because you'd rather be running the mill event.
I agree. This card is specifically good with the Ikuno Ichigo stuff, right?
I think that's the intention. I think in practice, this card's role is with the Chlorophytum early play. Since the Chlorophytum early play doesn't cost stock for its combo, so you can draw into this and then counter to protect them. And you can play one of this, maybe two, but you know, you play one of this in your split of presence, and you can grab it if you want it.
I can definitely see the value if you're playing blue already to play a split, but
this is one of the rewards for splashing.
It's cool with the Ichigo Brainstorm.
All right, now you want to know a card that's not cool? This next one, Hidden Feelings. This is a 1-0 event that just gives 3/5 power until the next end of your opponent's turn. Then this goes on the bottom of the deck.
Wow.
You know, I actually played this profile in Devil Survivor 2. I played it as a bond target.
Wait a second.
This card is that Devil Survivor card is worse than this one.
There's an injustice here that I must rectify. What?
What's going on?
Why are you
looking up a card?
Why is this free?
What do you mean?
Why is Pentecost Pendant costs stock because
you can't play this without a certain name.
I guess name restrict. Well, you can't play pendant if you have no key characters.
You're really on a crusade about this.
Also, pendant balancing thing. Not a 3/5 cannon.
I have yet to see two events that are not balanced correctly. But when you brought up the Nisekoi pendant thing and Nisekoi pendant versus. There's a noise.
Yeah. Magical girl appears versus. Huh? Versus
some
ignite
weird
module.
Noise coming out of your mic, yeah.
It was me scratching the mic. Magical girl appears versus ignite module red.
So, magical girl appears is not trait restricted, contrary to popular, like, recall. It's universal salvage. Salvages anything. Whereas, the Symphogear ignite module is trait restricted to music. The Nisekoi power counter pendant is differently worded. It says if you have no key, you can't play this. So it has a 500 power net detriment. Whereas the other pendant profiles that go to memory are 3K and give it to any traded character. So they're more restricted in who you can put it on. So I'm off the crusade against event balancing. I'm also off this card. This card sucks.
Yes.
This is why Bushiro can do whatever the hell they want, because they know there are people like Paddy Wagon here who will defend them no matter what. Kappa.
For this card to do anything, the card you put it on would need to not have died, but for this. Which isn't, you know, guaranteed. It might have lived anyway, possibly. And it also just needs to work. Like, the opponent can't kill it in response. That's a disaster. And the reward that you get out of it, like, you didn't even gain a card out of this. You traded a card in your hand to preserve a card on field. So that is, you might get an extra soul that you wouldn't otherwise, because maybe they have to crash or something.
Look, you're trading a card for either you're trading a card for either a card in some tempo or for nothing. Like, imagine if they trigger a wind trigger. nice card, idiot. So yeah, the downside is not actually that huge. Like, you're probably going to have a card that leads, sure, but it's not an impactful effect at all.
Yeah.
I just think that the impact is so low that putting in this deck is worse than putting in a level 0 vanilla in most of it.
Very similar to anything I've said about counters, honestly.
Yep.
Except worse, because there's no guarantee here.
That's blue done.